From Tattletale Cindy to Marsha, Marsha, Marsha. We all remember the Brady Bunch on the telly. It was wholesome family viewing for decades after its original run. Recently, Angela Bishop caught up with the oldest of the Brady boys, Greg, played by Barry Williams, for this exclusive interview.
Maybe I can find a rerun of a rerun I haven't seen.
Here's a story of a lovely lady.
It's hard to believe that one of TV's favourite families came onto our screens almost 50 years ago. But before the first episode aired in 1969, the show originally had a different name, The Bradley Brew. But they changed it and, well...
That's the way we all became the Brady Bunch.
Barry Williams played the oldest of the kids, Greg Brady.
Which one is Greg?
The big one.
Barry Williams, what a treat to chat to you today. Thank you so much for your time.
My pleasure.
And you're Johnny Bravo.
Today I am.
That is fantastic.
Because this is a day of meeting viewers, fans of the show, people that grew up with the Brady Bunch, and so I thought I'd come and, you know, my vest here and...
The little tiki
action.
From the Hawaii episode.
We came to the burial ground to bring back the little idol.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Barry was a triple threat. He could act, had good looks, and he could sing.
Time to change. That was when Peter's voice broke, wasn't it?
I know.
Time to change.
Peter was always getting in the way.
Stealing
throwing
it.
The football at Marsha.
Hey, you guys.
Dropping the basketball down in the living room, breaking Mom's favorite vase.
Oh, no!
Mom's favorite vase.
Then he lost his voice just when we were about to hit it big as recording artists.
And to think I knew those kids when they were just starting out.
Thank goodness I could write a song around it.
You did. I mean, true life, you and Christopher Knight are still good buddies, aren't you?
We are. Actually, all the kids are good friends. We all share the big events of our lives together and stay in touch and like having a second family.
Until late last year, part of that family was Florence Henderson, who played everyone's favourite mum, Carol Brady.
So I guess you all stuck together when Florence Henderson passed away.
She was an amazing lady. The things that she wanted to do more than anything else was make you laugh. And she would go to all kinds of lengths to do that. And sometimes her language and the nature of her sense of humour would be quite surprising.
I've got my friends in.
Just last week, Greg and three of his co-star siblings appeared on American TV to celebrate almost 50 years of the show and to remember their awesome TV mum.
You were all just terrific.
How did the six of you get through that? Did you get together? Did you?
Actually, there were three memorials for her. There was one that was mostly just family. Now, of course, she had two families.
Yep.
So we had the Brady family and her own family, four kids. And there was a public memorial in Los Angeles, and then I attended the one in New York City on Broadway.
That must have been a beautiful way
to
say goodbye.
It was. I sang there.
What did you sing, Barry?
It's a song called Gone Too Soon.
Wow. That would have been tough.
You have no idea. I practiced and I practiced and I practiced it so many times so that I didn't want to break down and get caught up in it.
Yeah.
So I didn't, but everyone else did. And that was just the way it was supposed to work.
Now, did you see any of your on-screen sister, Marsha, a.k.a. Maureen, when she starred on our Channel 10 show, I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here in the Jungle?
I did. I could hardly believe she was doing it. And she said it was one of the hardest things she's ever done. And she faced a lot of her fears. And she got down and literally dirty.
She sure did.
Yeah.
Would you ever do anything like that? Eat spiders, you know, eat offal and covered in maggots.
No problem. You know, I
you
do that. I do that now, and I don't get paid for it.
You got to be in love to love a love song.
Unlike so many child stars who've come undone later in life, Barry and his Brady Bunch seem to have made the most out of their early fame.
The six of you, though, did make it through. The six of you, your brothers and your Brady Bunch brothers and sisters.
Yeah, not without our struggles, but yes.
What do you think has got you through? You're six tough cookies, six good people.
For me, it's always just been keep my head down, keep going, doing the best work I can. One thing that's helped my career a lot is to be diversified. So I'm not depending on television or movies or production or writing or singing. I do all of that.
Yeah.
And have a ball with it, and it's great.
Despite the success of The Brady Bunch, it wasn't until decades later that the show reached the peak of its fame.
He's a pinball wizard that has to be a twisted.
Barry and the cast made much more money from variety shows than they ever did during the original 5 years the show ran.
Okay then, I'm ready, I'm here on time, but I don't know what the finale is. You never know what the finale is.
I believe congratulations are in order. You're getting married.
Hi, thank you.
And very soon.
And this time I think I'm going to get it right.
Tell me a little bit about your fiancée. Why do you love her to bits?
She's beautiful. I think I love her to bits because I trust her completely. Yeah. I know she has my back. She's a great partner. She's beautiful. Oh, she's age appropriate. That's important for me now. And
we got a lifetime to share.
He's referring to his one-time date with his TV mum, Florence Henderson, admitting to the fact the pair once went on an innocent date.
I kind of felt like I was, if you were in school and I were the teacher, because he loved the fact that I could sing and I knew a lot about music, and so he was really drawn to me for that reason, and I think developed a crush for that reason. But he was a cute kid.
Well, thank you so much for chatting to me today, Barry.
Thank you so much.
Really nice to chat. Appreciate it.
Good on you.
Ah, nice. Oh, how good's your Australian accent? Just give me a bit more.
Not very good.